zone and this zone?
Yes, both amplitudes.
So this is here progesterone from D-axis cardiogesterone, 21 hydroxylase will act, okay? So when there is a deficiency, there is no further stress, okay? And here, 17 hydroxyl progesterone, there is no deficiency of 21 hydroxylase, there is no cortisol, okay? And second one is, another one is 17 hydroxy progesterone, okay?
Progesterone.
So it is a byproduct, it is part of the synthesis of the progesterone. So it is made in the serum, plasma and saliva of the babies, that is neonatal screening, okay? Neonatal screening, we are using to measure 17 hydroxy progesterone. So to find out any congenital adrenal hyperplasia, okay? So because 21 alpha, there are 2 enzymes, that is 21 hydroxylase and 11 hydroxylase is there. It is increased the same. It increased several hundred times than normal. It has a deficiency of the, if there any genetic disorder or any congenital adrenal hyperplasia, the levels of the 17 hydroxyl progesterone will increase 100 times than normal. So it is made by the ADMUNA-SA or other immunoassays, okay? So enzyme deficiency go 21 hydroxylase, okay? So what are the, yes? Yeah, then there is a deficiency of the 21 hydroxylase, increase urinary cortisol and 17 KS, what is the meaning of KS? Ketosteroids, okay? 17 ketosteroids and increased plasma 17 deoxy progesterone, okay? And so what are the tests for genetic? So we are going for the CYP21 gene test, okay? To treatment, to identify if it is adrenal insufficiency congenital or not. Likewise, 11 hydroxylase, increased serum 11 deoxy cortisol and urinary 17 hydroxy is hydroxycorticosteroids, okay? Hydroxycorticosteroids and 17 ketosteroids. So CYP 11B, 1 and 2 genes are responsible for this disorder, okay? So how you measure this genetic test? It will, what is the procedure for genetic test? Karyotyping, and what are the instruments? So we will go for the molecular badge, okay? Like PCR, Western blotting, okay? We are going for the molecular badge, PCR. So we can modify the, we can amplify the genes, and we will do the positive, the gene which we know the sequence. Then there is a binding, then we will find he has the congenital adrenal deficiency. So next one is Kahn's syndrome, that is hyperaldosteronism, okay? Hyperaldosteronism, that is called Kahn's disease. This is due to primary adrenal tumor with low renin. So this is mainly due to the primary adrenal tumors with low renin activity. And secondly, to the high renin angiotensin system, okay? What are the findings? Laboratory plasma and urinary systems show high levels of aldosterone. Serum potassium is low, urinary potassium is high, and hypernatremia, okay? With level of sodium. So renin is the low in primary, high in secondary. This is our cause for the hyperaldosteronism. This is called Kahn's disease. So investigation for adrenal cortical functions also include the genetic testing of the enzyme deficiency. Okay? So genetic, if you go for genetic testing, compulsory 90% that is the enzyme deficiency. Then only you can say that is the genetic disorder. Hypoaldosteronism. So this is defective of the aldosterone synthesis. Is there any abnormality in the synthesis of the aldosterone? Then it is called hypoaldosteronism. So primary with the, it is the renin level are high, okay? Before, that is the primary is low level of the renin level. Secondary, hypoanemia means decreased level of the renin in the blood. Hypoanemia in heparin injection. So it includes hypotension, dehydration, hyponatremia and hyperkalemia. So far we covered adrenal cortex, okay? Adrenal cortex. So what are the adrenal cortex? This is yes.
Hyper.
What are the hyper?
Gustatory syndrome
and
Cushing syndrome only. All, okay?
Yes.
And hypo? Okay, what about the genetic disorders? Deficiency of which genders?
21, 11, 7.
So is it clear, huh? So next one is pheochromocytoma. Pheochromocytoma. It is a tumor of medulla. And one more thing, neuroblastoma. This is also a tumor of medulla, okay? But the important one is pheochromocytoma. This is a tumor of medulla which overproduce adrenaline, okay? Overproduce adrenaline and non-adrenaline, but the adrenaline level are heavy, more, too much, okay? But in case of neuroblastoma, non-adrenaline is more. Understand what is the difference between the pheochromocytoma and pheochromocytoma? Here the adrenal level are excess, but in neuroblastoma the non-adrenal level are excess than adrenal. What are the symptoms? Continuous or intermittent high blood pressure, chest pain, fast heartbeat with palpation, weight loss, sweats, flushing and headache. Neuroblastoma, the malignant tumor of the neuroblast, most common adrenal medulla, with excess production of non-adrenaline, okay, than adrenaline. Here, adrenaline is more. So, what are the tests for the pheochromocytoma? Clonidine suppression test. So, clonidine suppression test is useful to detect if the patient have pheochromocytoma or not. What is the principle? So clonidine is a, what is clonidine?
Clonidine salt.
It's a drug, okay? It's an aromatic group of drugs. So it binds to the alpha 2 adrenal receptor, okay? It binds to the alpha 2 adrenal receptor, mimics. Mimics means what? What is the meaning of mimic? Represent. Acting like catecholamines, okay? So when you use the catecholamines, it acts to the alpha 2 adrenal receptors in the brain. It mimics like a catecholamines. So and reduce the activity of the sympathetic nervous system that control the adrenal medulla. But this clonidine cannot control the. But this type of, for example, if you use the clonidine, okay, to the patient, it act attached with the alpha 2 adrenal receptors in the brain, okay. So what is the function of catecholamine? The same, it also binds to the alpha 2 receptors in the brain. But when you use the clonidine for the patient, it will go and act. That is, go for the competition, like as I said, antigen antibody by labeled antigen, unlabeled antigen, like that. It will go and bind to the alpha 2 receptor and adrenal receptors of the brain and mimic. It acts like a catecholamines, okay? Function like a catecholamines, reduce the activity of the sympathetic nervous system which controls the adrenal medulla, but cannot control the pheochromocytoma cells, okay? The pheochromocytoma cells which are present in the adrenal producing the epinephrine and non-epinephrine. So what happened? It controls the sympathetic nervous system, but it cannot control the cells which produce epinephrine and non-epinephrine in the medulla. But if you go for the catecholamines, if you use catecholamines, it can control both, okay? Because this is a natural product of the medulla. It can control both. Production of epinephrine, non-epinephrine can control by the catecholamines, okay? But when you use the polyurethane, it can control the sympathetic nervous system, but it cannot control the epinephrine and non-epinephrine production.
So, when it stimulates cells, which is stimulating the chromatin cells,
the other cells which can control the sympathetic, but especially for pheochromocytoma cells, which cannot control the pheochromocytoma cells. Okay? So, Barnum, the CST helps to differentiate the normal from abnormal persons. So, it can differentiate this case from the normal person to pheochromocytoma disease person. So, 0.3 milligram of polyurethane is given orally, okay? After 2 baseline sample for epinephrine and non-epinephrine of the so samples are different from the others. So, first we have to give 0.3 mg of polyurethane to the patient. To collect the baseline sample of the epinephrine and non-epinephrine are obtained. Sample is repeated 3 hours after. Again, we have to take the first, we have to take the samples of the epinephrine, non-epinephrine from the patient. First of all, okay. So, after given the polyurethane 0.3 mg, after 3 hours, we have to take again the samples to estimate epinephrine and non-epinephrine. Clear? First, we have to take the sample of the patient. So estimate the epinephrine, non-epinephrine levels, okay? Then we have to give 0.3 mg of the polyurethane after 3 hours. After 3 hours, again we have to take a sample. Then we have to estimate the epinephrine, non-epinephrine. So if polyurethane fails to suppress the catecholamine secretion in the pheochromocytoma patients, while restored with the normal catecholamine in other, say, if polyurethane fails to suppress, decrease the production of the catecholamine secretion in the cells, that is the pheochromocytoma patients, while restored normal catecholamines in other hyperadrenergic states. Means, so this also indicates, is there any other diseases like hyperadrenergic states, means any other hyperadrenal medulla disorders is there. So this test means differentiate from the pheochromocytoma from other disorders, okay? Especially it will indicate, it will decide the patient have pheochromocytoma or not, clearly.
To differentiate,
okay? Because it fails to suppress the catecholamine secretion in, it fails. As I mentioned, polyurethane, when you give the polyurethane to the patient, it will control the sympathetic nervous system, but it cannot control the production of the catecholamines. That is epinephrine, non-epinephrine.
Now we know if I take the sample from the patients from the
levels of the epinephrine, non-epinephrine, okay? If you take the sample of the patient, first you know the normal value of the,
yeah.
Okay, first of all. Our abnormal patient will get the abnormal, some range. When you give the polyurethane, the epinephrine, non-epinephrine decrease means is the normal person. If it is not able to decrease, again, it is same or increase means it is not able to control. But it controls the sympathetic, but cannot control the production of epinephrine, non-epinephrine. But in other disorders, that is hyperadrenergic state, other diseases, so the normal catecholamines are restored. It can be restored, okay? But in pheochromocytoma, it cannot be restored.
So, it is much better.
Hypotension.
How this one, I did 0.22 alpha C2, I do it better for me. It's mimic, it is much better.
Mimic? Mimic means what? Mimic means represent. Just he is acting like you. But functionally, will be not same. But he is acting like you, that's all. he is acting like you, but the function is not same. But the function is both same means the catecholamine should control the production of the epinephrine and norepinephrine. Okay? But both are same, but functions are different. So, and increase other test to confirm the colonel's pheochromocytoma, the other test is estimation of the plasma epinephrine and norepinephrine, and increase the urinary valine, mandelic acid and metanephrine. These two are the end products of the epinephrine. Okay, these are the tests to confirm the patient whether he has pheochromocytoma or not. So any doubts? Okay.
Thank you.